If you want Python and Java to integrate for sure and don't want to waste time guessing Gradle build and Python versions that actually work, this video may be for you. Watch until the end for a handy tip to make Java and Python code work for Android with Chaqoupy. Welcome to a video on how to make Python and Java work together for Android using Chaqoupy. We will use Android Studio as our development environment. First, let's create a project on Android Studio. Select Empty Views activity. I'm going to name my application My App. For SDK, I'm choosing the development language as Java and the minimum version as API 21, which estimates that our app will run on 99.6% of devices. By the way, the official description for Chaqoupy is that it is a Python SDK for Android. Choose build configuration language as Groovy DSL. Choosing Groovy DSL is kind of important as I find that some instructions and Gradle syntax given on the official Chaqoupy website don't work well with Kotlin DSL, even though Kotlin DSL is recommended by Android Studio. Once the project is created, give it some time for Gradle project synchronization to complete. A Java class main activity is now created in the process. Activity_main.xml provides some basic layout and widgets for the skin of our Android application. Let's head to the basic setup for Chaqoupy. Expand Gradle scripts and open the project build.gradle. Head to the official Chaqoupy instructions on this webpage. I've provided the URL on your screen. Copy the Gradle plugin from the basic setup section and paste it to the project build.gradle. Open the module build.gradle and copy the module level plugin to the module build.gradle. If you already have one of the entries, delete the duplicate. Next, copy the NDK with application binary interface filters to the app build.gradle. This relates to the ABIs to be supported by the native Python interpreter in Android. We want to trim the ABI filters to reduce the size of our app and limit support to the newer Android devices with ARM64-V8A. The x86_64 ABI filter allows us to run the app on Android Studio emulator on Windows, which is why I have retained that filter in our build specification. Next, copy the Python version to use. We will use version 3.11 as that version seems to work well with Python function calls and data type interpretations from Java. Python 3.11 is compatible with the current latest version 14.0 of Chaqoupy and supports Gradle versions as shown. We will see later in the video that we use Gradle for this setup. We then specify the location of the Python executable on our local machine where we are setting up the project. Keep the relevant entry and delete the others. after this, we configured the location of Python source code under default configuration. This location is where we write our Python scripts. By default, Chaqoupy looks for Python source code under Python subdirectory on each source set. We will use only one source set here, so we will name our Python source code location like so. Now, we need to write Python startup code inside our Java class mainActivity.java. Copy the startup code from Chaqoupy and paste it inside the onCreate method. The context, as documented by Chaqoupy, can be an activity object from our app. Therefore, we can reference the main activity instance here for context. Class Python needs to be imported. Now, for some reason, Android Studio did not offer me a class import pop-up here, so I had to manually import the class. As Chaqoupy is showing in red, it tells me that I have to sync the Chaqoupy plugin to my Gradle build. And now the class Python has been successfully imported. Next, I import Android platform class as required by the Python startup code. Now it's time to head to our project view and navigate to the source directories. We should be expecting a Python source folder to be created anytime soon, as per our Gradle build configuration. The Python source folder is now created. I right-click that folder and create our Python script myhelper.py in that folder. I'm going to create a simple Python function that accepts a list of integers, sorts them, and returns a NumPy array from the sorted list. With the Python function implemented, we want to call the Python function from our Java class mainActivity.java. We are going to add this code to the onCreate method. Get an instance of Python and use this to attach a PyObject instance to the MyHelper Python module. Now, we can invoke Python functions in MyHelper with this PyObject instance. Again, somehow I had to manually import the PyObject class as well. We create a second object to access the simple underscore sort function implemented in Python. Next, we declare a Java array of unsorted integers and pass this array as an argument to our call to Python function simple underscore sort. The print statement prints the output of the Python function returned to Java, which is a sorted NumPy array of integers. Let's run the app on the emulator on Android Studio. Give it a while to build and launch the app. We can see an exception thrown by the app in the logcat window. We have not configured the Python NumPy library in our build, even though we have an import statement for NumPy in our Python script. Head to the requirements section on Chaqoupy instructions webpage. Copy the Python package install lines in our Gradle build and retain only one line for NumPy at this time. Let's sync our Gradle build with the NumPy package install. Rerun the app. Now we get a new exception. This time, there is a problem of interpreting the Java array of integers passed to the Python function simple underscore sort as a Python list. And therefore, there is a problem invoking the Python list function sort. To work around this issue, we cast the argument my underscore list to a Python list type, and then call the sort function on it. Let's rerun the app. We can see that the app has successfully launched and executed the Java Python code sections as well. Here's the print statement from within the Python function simple underscore sort. And here's the Java print statement printing the sorted array of integers, which was output from Python. It looks like we are able to gracefully end the process on the emulator. Like so. So this completes the installation and successful execution of a minimal app that interoperates Java and Python through Chaqoupy for Android. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and share with your friends. Comment below with what other steps we can incorporate or what pitfalls we need to avoid in managing evolving Gradle and Chaqoupy versions for Java and Python integration. Here's the Gradle version details for the setup used in this video.